Brother, mainstream media, government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. He's Richard Wood with Z News.
We are live, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you once again for joining us for this, the 15th podcast edition of Z News, which is a compendium of information on business, finance, economics, and social and political issues worldwide, reaching over 10,000 subscribers. Parts of this publication are picked up by 60 different websites weekly, exposing our ideas to over 10 million investors a week. It is Tuesday, the 8th day of February, 2011. Coming up on the show today, Greece and Ireland slide towards default, and troubles in the home front with seizures, outflows of money. Both Ireland and Greece and the others are fraught with pitfalls for mainly Germany and the other solvent Euro members. This is why Germany is discussing, behind closed doors, leaving the Eurozone and reintroducing the D-mark. We believe that will happen. In the process, they will leave the EU as well. The Irish story is huge, yet it is virtually out of the news. Great damage is being done to the Euro, but for that matter, no currency is safe. The only safe havens are gold and silver related assets. In Ireland, the situation worsens as PM Brian Cowan, who sold Ireland out to the elitist bankers, announces an earlier than expected general election on Friday, March 11, 2011. Cowan has been bombed in the polls since the $114 billion bank bailout, which will bring about his political demise. It will also spell the end of the reign of Fianna Fáil and the re-emergence of Fine Gael. It is another fine mess the compromisers have gotten Ireland into. Like in so many countries, politicians have been bought from all parties, and that has created a total disconnect between the leadership of the parties and their constituents. There is nothing dumb about the financial media. They know exactly what they are doing. All they want to do is keep their jobs, and in that process, they sell out themselves, their families and friends, other people, and their country. They know government statistics are bogus, but they won't report that because if they did, they will be discharged. There are two sets of alternate figures. One shows inflation at 6.75% and the other 8%. As we have reported before, the PPI reflects 13.5% to 14%. So how can official inflation be 1.2%? If this is truly the case, how can inflation be tamed with food and energy prices going through the roof? What we are seeing are the results of QE1 and QE2 in the form of growing inflation. That is our gift from Chairman Ben Bernanke. The recovery he envisions can only be translated into some kind of temporary relief, which is the product of monetary distortion, not recovery. In addition, observers can see higher sales but never factor in the growth of inflation. That is why the CPI figures are distorted as much as they are officially by government. This year will be a classic inflation year, with prices rising in all sectors. We see current inflation at 6.75%, and by the year that should be 14%. If you refer back to CPI U, it is 6.2%, the CPI W 7.8%, and the 1980 SGS of 8.9%, you can see that 14% is a very tame number. If we have to guess, in December the official CPI will beat 5.5%. In November of 2004, we predicted housing starts would fall 75% during the coming housing correction, up from 70% during the 1989 to 92 correction. Thus far, the correction is just under 80%. During this past final quarter of 2010, starts fell at a more accelerated pace, which does not augur well for the economy. This slowing will present a formidable headwind for recovery. In 2011 and 2012, we see house prices falling 20%. The promiscuous lending and syndication of mortgages that has so ruined lenders' balance sheets will be with us for years to come, unless, of course, they do the right thing and declare bankruptcy. Much the same has happened in parts of Europe and is presently occurring in Asia, particularly in China. Monetary and then price inflation has taken hold worldwide because almost all governments have been using the same Keynesian policies. No current country will escape the deflationary depression which is on the way. There will just be degrees of misery. QE1 and QE2 can be credited for the most part with today's and the coming inflation. What is deeply disturbing is that the Fed, Treasury and most economists know that throwing money and credit at the problem is not going to work. Is the Fed just hoping that it will work just this one time? Or are they being deliberately destructive? We believe it is deliberate. You make your own choice. The food riots we see worldwide will worsen, and in some countries, revolution will follow. You will see more of what you just saw in Tunisia, where the president's wife flees the country due to the upheaval and doesn't forget to take 1.5 tons of gold with her. Upward pressure on prices is caused in part by growing populations of what the Bilderbergers call the useless eaters. It is surprising these elitists haven't as yet begun World War III. That would help solve that problem. QE1 was a save the financial sectors in the US, UK and Europe. And QE2 is to save the US government. Very little, if any, of these funds have benefited the public. The direct effects of these rescues is much higher inflation. Unemployment has only fallen from 22.58% to 22.25% over the past 3 months. December saw a great acceleration in inflation, and that will carry forward for at least 2 years as QE3 becomes reality. Real GDP growth is -1.5%, and even with QE2, it will only be 2 to 2.25% at a cost of another $2.5 trillion. M3 is down 2.5% to 3%, but don't be deceived, there are other ways to increase money and credit. The path of QE2 and then QE3 will lead to hyperinflation. How soon? We don't know, but you can plan on it coming. That is why gold and silver related assets are so important. They are your only refuge. In order to keep the system from collapsing, we have zero interest rates and quantitative easing. This may prolong the agony for the elitists, but it also causes higher inflation. One of the subscribers says she went to a swap meet and there were no bargains. Purchasing power is falling every day. As an overview of last week's Hollywood theatrics at the White House between a Chinese dictator in serious trouble and an illegal alien who desperately wanted higher poll numbers. The real meetings were in secret, and the rest was a stage play, which included smoke and mirrors. Our sources tell us all over China there are demonstrations and riots, over 35% inflation and demand for higher wages. That country is in deep trouble as the housing bubble bursts and the stock market falls. Periodically, bank reserve ratios are raised, but they have not delivered the desired results. We see the Chinese economy slowing over the next few years as the world economy slows. That could cause 40 million people to be unemployed. They have built whole cities that are empty. They were simply make work projects. That means the US and other economies will be negatively affected as well. China has serious problems that in time will lead to the sale of US dollars on a major basis. 2011 is going to be a year to remember. It could be the beginning of a major collapse that is without an untoward event taking place. Almost everything the US and Europe have attempted has not worked. Could it be another Lehman Brothers or Bear Stearns or a major bank going under? We will see the fall in financial stocks that we have been awaiting for so long. Before signing off today, we would like to thank all of our subscribers for making these broadcasts happen. None of this would have been possible without your continued valuable support. New listeners are able to follow me on Twitter at Richard J. Wood or the Z News feed on our Facebook fan page for the latest stories we are following and to hear my regular radio interviews on the air or online. Also, don't forget to like and also to share these podcasts with your Twitter followers and your Facebook friends. On the program tomorrow, the corporation is not a person, and a government that spends most of what it has. Be sure to join us then. I'm Richard Wood, and this has been Z News, because you can handle the truth.